Yes.
He said that this year has been a year of pain, but I've come to restore you because I'm in a hurry. I've come to bring you into divine order. And the Spirit of the Lord said, I am refreshing you. I'm resetting you. And I'm releasing unto you my spirit. He said, and signs and wonders and miracles is going to increase. They're going to follow you. And the Spirit of the Lord said, to continue in the faith, to continue to seek my faith. And he says that much is given and much is required. But I have called you to cross over into my blessing. And today I have released my blessing unto you. And what was held up before shall be released unto you. The Spirit of the Lord said, be in expectancy. But don't forget me, the Spirit of the Lord said, that I am getting ready to bless you. And those things that was held back shall come forth in 2018. But the Spirit of the Lord said, continue to seek my face. Continue in the faith, the Spirit of the Lord said.
Yes.
For much is given and much is required, said the Spirit of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We bless your holy name, Lord God. Thank you, God. None like you, Lord God. None like you, Lord God.
Glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You may be seated if you can.
Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
We're going to go into the message. I never write my messages in a sermon form. I just take notes and study. So however that it come out, it came out straight from the press. Whatever arrangement that it go in, it came from the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm just going to submit to him this morning. And so if you're one that takes notes and you're really serious about your journey, I'm going to go ahead and give you several scriptures. You can write it down. And then you can just go back and meditate on it. I may not get to the scriptures. I don't know what the Holy Spirit is going to do. But if you are ready, say amen.
Amen.
You ready? Okay. I'm gonna quickly give you these scriptures. I'm gonna give you Judges. Chapter 16. 4 through 5, and then 10 through 21. I'm going to give you Luke 8, 5 through 15. I'm going to give you Matthew 11, verse 30. Isaiah 55, 10 through 11. And then Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27. I know it's a lot of scriptures. Zechariah 4 and 6. Galatians 5 and 1. Deuteronomy 15, verses 1 through, I'll let y'all know now. Okay, and then Revelations 3 and 17. Amen. All right. We can definitely go to Judges. I don't know how much time I have or anything. Judges 16. All right, before we go into reading the scriptures, I guess God wanted me to rest because some of y'all don't know, but I've been sick and throwing up and all that stuff. But I thank God for what he did on the cross. Hallelujah. I thank God that I don't have to stay the same way. And so through all of that, I was just praying and locked up in my room yesterday and seeking the face of God. And he began to give me several things concerning the year, several things. But one of the main things that he wants you all to know is he wants you to know that his incorruptible seed is still growing and flourishing. And I understand that the church always get a bad name from the social media and all the media and all that. They're ridiculing the church and talking about the church and playing the church like the church is weak. And people are falling away, they losing hope. But the Spirit of the Lord wants you to know that the church is a seed, is an incorruptible seed, and it cannot be stopped.
Amen.
And is yet growing and flourishing.
Yeah.
That he is raising up a remnant of people that are growing and prospering, and they are not backing down. They're not compromising. They're not passive. But they're walking in the supernatural power of God. And God says that in 2018, that I am going to give my remnant double anointing. He also began to tell me that the remnant is getting ready to manifest his power like never before.
Yes.
That his remnant are prayer warriors. And he says that my remnant seek my face, not out of obligation or tradition, but they seek my face because they love me. And he says that, he said, those remnant, he said, whatever that they touch is going to explode. And people are going to see the manifestation of the power of God. And it's going to cause others to turn to Christ. So this is the reason why he is, one of the reasons why that he is intensifying the anointing. He's giving you double. And he says, because I have to give you double because what is taking place in the land.
Yeah.
But he says for you to keep growing and to keep flourishing and seeking my face. He says, know that no weapon formed against you is going to prosper. And know that I have already brought you out. There is already a way out of no way.
Amen.
And so the Spirit of the Lord says that one of the spirits that has been released into the land, and you all have been seeing it, is the Laodicean church. This is what he told me. And he said that the Laodicean church, they are full of people. You can read that in Revelation 3 and 17. He said they are packing the house, but he says don't be moved by that.
Yes.
He said this is the age of lukewarm.
Yes.
And that's why you're wondering, what is going on? How are these churches flocking? And they are increasing in goods and money and all that, but they are lukewarm. Wow. He said, and recognize them because they have taken salvation out.
Yes.
That you can't even tell whether or not they really have the gospel, whether the gospel is there or not. You can't see the death, burial, resurrection teaching in there. He said they're denying the power thereof. They have compromised. They're not hot or cold. They just lukewarm, standing in the middle. And the Spirit of the Lord said, beware.
Wow, yes.
Because they're increasing. But I'm raising up a remnant of people that's going to walk in the supernatural, and God and the people, the sinners, is going to recognize the difference.
Wow.
Yes.
So because of that, he has to double the anointing. He said there will be visitations, angelic visitations that will come your way.
Yes.
He's also, he said that there are going to be an open door for you. An open door. Where things where it seemed like it was on delay before, you're going to see him moving suddenly. Okay, so then I also saw where he said that what you went through this year, he says that it was meant to change your attitude. So I began to look up attitude. So I said, okay, change. You're changing their attitude, the body of Christ attitude. So I looked it up and I said, okay, God, what is the attitude? Because I began to feel a certain type of way. And he began to let me know what you're feeling is what I'm placing on the body. What they went through this year, it was to bring them into a new place. And I'm going to explain that before we get into the word. So I looked up attitude, and it says attitude is a settled way of thinking or feeling about someone or something. Okay, I'm gonna read it again. Know why? Because I can't read my handwriting. Okay. Okay, so bear with me. All right, so an attitude is a settled way of thinking or feeling about someone or something, typically on okay, so he says that it reflects a person's behavior, standpoint, or position. Y'all with me?
Amen.
All right. So he says that an attitude is a settled way of thinking or feeling about someone or something, typically on the way a person, on, y'all please forgive me. Let me see. Pastor had to ask me what I said again. All right, so the attitude reflects in a person's behavior, standpoint, or position. All right, standpoint or position. In other words, an attitude is a mental position. It's a mental position. Okay, so now look at this. An attitude will determine just how much your future you will accomplish.
Wow.
Your attitude. Alright, so stay with me. Here's a quote. Our lives are not determined by what happened to us, but by how we react to what happens.
Yeah.
Not by what life brings to us, but by the attitude we bring to life.
Wow.
A positive attitude causes a chain reaction of positive thoughts, events, and outcome.
Mm-hmm.
So the Spirit of the Lord was showing me that He had to get you to shift your attitude. Because what was going on is you had a wrong attitude about your trials and the things that you were going to. So your attitude was more like hopeless.
Wow.
And when things hit you, you was more like dragging your feet. And some of us promoted the enemy. You know, the enemy doing this and the enemy doing that, but it wasn't enough magnifying the Lord. But the Lord said that I had to reposition you to be able to get what you needed to get in 2018. But the only way that you can get it is that you have to change your attitude, because your attitude will bring a chain of results.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Okay, so y'all with me?
Yes.
So the Lord has released a warrior type spirit upon you for 2018.
Yes.
In a nutshell, that's what it is. What you compromised before, you got a different perspective. Because now you're not going to take it no more.
Hallelujah.
And it's going to be so, you know what the scripture says, that you are more than a conqueror? You are going to rise up in it and you are going to conquer.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Because it's like you already been down below and it's like, you know what, I can't go no farther no more.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And anyway, the enemy, I'm not scared of you no more. And gift of knowledge is going to increase upon you.
Yes.
He says that souls are going to come into the kingdom like never before.
Yes.
And I even saw where celebrities, God is raising up people that even celebrities are going to hit. It's like I can see them falling to their knees. And the Holy Spirit was turning the wheel.
Yes.
And He was turning the wheel, and that wheel was representing that total alignment.
Yes.
So like I was saying before, it's like how a chiropractor snapped you back when you've been in an accident.
Yes.
Some of you all been in some accident moments.
Wow.
That caused you to be out of alignment.
Yes.
And the only way that you can fight is through the word of God.
Amen.
And one of the last things, I'm not going to get to all of it because he was just downloading. But one of the last things was that he said that if two animals that reflects his character. And because you are, God is taking you into a new place, he said, your new place, you must represent my attribute, my ways, my character. So he uses the lion and the eagle. Hallelujah. And so the lion, you got to remember, the lion and the eagle, they represent the highest ranking in their kingdom.
Amen.
And so he says that the lion is who he is and is respected because of his attitude.
Yes. Yes.
And he said that when you change your attitude, he said you're going to find favor, because when you walk in, my nature, my presence is going to demand people to give unto you.
Prayer
that I may fall upon you.
Yes.
could just end it with this. All right, this is what I saw. Holy Spirit, help me. Judges chapter 16 deals with Delilah and Samson. So I'm going to read verse 4 and 5. Y'all with me?
Yes.
It says, and it came to pass afterwards that he loved a woman in the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. Delilah means temptress. Like a female tempter. That's how I look at it. And the lords of the Philistines came up unto her and said unto her, entice him. You need to underline that. And see wherein his great strength lies. You need to underline that. And by what means we may prevail against him. Underline that. That we may bind him to afflict him, underline that. And we will give thee every one of us 1,100 pieces of silver, underline that. And verse 6 says, and Delilah said to Samson, tell me, I pray thee, wherein thy great strength lie, and wherewith thou may be bound to afflict. And wherewith thou might be bound to afflict thee. And Samson said unto her, if they bind me with 7 green, with that were never dry, then shall I be weak and be as another man. Then the lords of the Philistines brought up to her 7 green with which had not been dried, and she bound him with them. Now there were men lying in wait, abiding, underline that. Now there were men lying in wait, abiding with her in the chamber. And she said unto him, the Philistine be upon thee, Samson. And he break the whip, and as a tread of tow is broken, when it touched the fire, so his strength was not known. And Delilah said unto Samson, behold, thou hast mocked me and told me lies. Now tell me, I pray thee, wherewith thou might be bound. And he said unto her, if they bind me fast with new ropes that never were occupied, then shall I be weak and be as another man. Delilah therefore took new ropes and bound him therewith, and said unto him, the Philistine be upon thee, Samson. And there were liars in wait, abiding in the chamber. And he brake them from off his arms like a thread. And Delilah said unto Samson, hereto thou hast mocked me and told me lies. Tell me wherewith thou might be bound. And he said unto her, if thou weavest the 7 locks, underline that, 7 locks of my head with the web. And she fastened it with the pin and said unto him, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he awaked out of his sleep and went away with the pin of the beam and with the web. Y'all with me?
Yes.
All right. 15. And she said unto him, how can thou say I love thee, underline that, when thy heart is not with me? Thou hast mocked me these 3 times and hast not told me wherein thy great strength lies. Manipulation. And it came to pass when she pressed him daily with her words. Underline that. She pressed him daily with her words and urged him so that his soul was vexed unto death, that he told her all his heart and said unto her, there have not come a razor upon my head, for I have been a Nazarite unto God from my mother's womb. If I be shaven, then my strength would go from me, and I shall become weak and be like any other man. And when Delilah saw that he had told her all his heart, she sent and called for the lords of the Philistines, saying, come up this once, for he has showed me all his heart. Then the lords of the Philistines came up unto her and brought money in their hand. And the last two verses. And she made him sleep upon her knees, and she called for a man. Okay, underline that, sleep. And she caused him to shave off the seven locks of his head. And she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him. Underline that. And she said, the Philistines be upon me, Samson. And he awoke out of sleep and said, I will go out as at other times before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. Underline that.
Jesus.
When we look at this story, the Holy Spirit wanted me to remind you all that Samson is representing Christ, a type of Christ, and also he's representing the church. And Delilah is representing the enemy, and also representing a destiny snatcher. And I want you to see, because the Holy Spirit kept telling me, Delilah, Delilah, the spirit of Delilah. So it's either going to be Jezebel that's going to try to change the course and the direction that God has spoken or promised you concerning destiny. Or it's going to be the spirit of Delilah. And Delilah wants to find out your strength. So Delilah would go so far, it could be a male or a female, but it's the spirit. The ultimate goal is to cause you to lose strength, because your strength is in the anointing. And it is in your position. Now,